In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
God, the Father of us all, in Jesus, your Son, and our Savior, you have made us your sons and daughters of the family of the Church. May your grace and love help our families in every part of the world be united to one another in fidelity to the gospel. May the example of the Holy Family, the aid of your Holy Spirit, guide all families, especially those most troubled, to be homes of communion and prayer, and to always seek your truth and live in your love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Боже, всіх нас, через Христа Твого Сина, нашого Спасителя, і зробив нас своїми синами, дочками, прийти церкви. Дай Твоя ласка і любов, поможе наша людина, Божі чистий світ, з'єднатися в одній злобі, вірити в цій Марії. Нехай приклик Святої Родини, за допомогою та Святого Твого Духа, провадить всіма родинами, особливо
two women who have been working quite diligently for the last many months, planning for next year's event in Philadelphia, the World Meeting of Families. Lizanne and Garrison Pando and Danielle McMonagle. They are Director of Marketing Communications and the Assistant Director of Marketing Communications. Their responsibilities include directing the website on the World Meeting of Families, magazines, mailings, TV, newspaper advertising, merchandising, marketing, public relations, and media, social media. As everybody know by now, next September 22nd to 27th, the City of Brotherhood will host the World Meeting of Families. And these two individuals will present what they're working on and give you an overview of the complexity and the interesting aspects of this event. So we're pleased to welcome Lizanne and Danielle. Thank you.
This is the eighth World Meeting of Families. It was first instituted by St. John Paul II in 1994, and it has been all over the world, but never in the United States before. So this is a very exciting time for us. The last one in 2012 was in Milan. And so some people from our office, when they first came on, went to Milan so that they could see how they did it. What kind of numbers did you have? What was your traffic flow like? Where was the security? What was working? What didn't work for you? So I'm going to ask you to go to the next slide because I can't remember. So in Milan, there was about 7,000 people who attended the conference for the 4 days. Our 4 days would be September 22nd through the 25th inside the Philadelphia Convention Center. We expect 15,000, or maybe even more than that. In Milan, they had 350,000 people attend their Saturday night Festival of Families, where it's a liturgical dance and song, and the Philadelphia Orchestra would come and wonderful acts, and it would be cultural and a wonderful experience, and then the Holy Father attends, and five families from five different continents were chosen by the Roman Pontifical Council give witness of their family and faith to our Holy Father. That would be on the parkway for us, just like the Mass will be the next day. They had 350,000, we expect a million. And then the Papal Mass on Sunday on the parkway, they had 1.5 million, we expect two or more. We expect more than this, 1.5 million. He hasn't been here before, and we just really feel there's been a lot of excitement about this World Meeting of families, from this, what I would call a year-long conversation of families with the Holy Father. And so I think a lot of people are reaching out and wanting to be a part of this program. So the first goal that we try to stay focused on is, we are the host diocese. We were chosen. And so we want to help that re-energize our diocese in Philadelphia and our church and our faith. Okay? The second goal is to strengthen family bonds and highlight the role of family. I think, as we had said, there's a year-long conversation going on about this. Holy Father is very focused on this. We all are. And it's a wonderful time to get everybody talking about the joys and the positives of family and how we can work together to strengthen those bonds. This is a great opportunity to spend a year talking about that with your parishes and the people that you minister to. And then to showcase Philadelphia and the region in an unprecedented way to the global audience. We expect 5,000 press to come to Philadelphia. You're going to be global after that. So the Catechesis is a year-long document to be studied. We have, it's 10 chapters, and we have it online, and we also have the prayer cards online as well. Many parishes are choosing to take the 10 themes and starting in November, taking the 10 months to talk about those 10 themes one at a time. We also have children's curriculums that people are using. You can download it for free off of our website. The CCD teams, prep teams, schools through K through 12 are using to really get the conversation and the children focused on the emphasis of the family as well, and the parishes. So these are wonderful tools to really engage everyone in the conversation and guide you right through. These are the 10 themes of the Catechesis. And if you can see here, it's really talking about every aspect of family. But a lot of it also, they didn't want it to be all about the challenges of working in the family. They wanted to talk about the joy of family and bringing joy to your family and how do we concentrate on that as well. Even in tough times, how can we find the blessings? Things of that nature. So that's truly in this book as well, when you get a chance to read it. It will also be a youth congress for 6 years old to 17 years old. That's going to be much more of an engaging, service-oriented, through dance and song, and the mural arts program is going to bring a large mural in, probably as big as this wall behind me, to be painted throughout the week, like paint by numbers. And so the children will get to paint it, families will get to paint it, and then they'll go on a wall in Philadelphia and it'll be a beautiful spiritual rendition of family so that we can memorialize our event here inside Philadelphia. But it's truly what we've created and brought to them. And we have other programs I'll touch on for the kids. But we have saints who will be walking the halls. Who am I? You know, things like that, and we're gonna try to do it in different languages as well, so everyone can participate. And the Horticultural Society wants to do a program, and we're talking about, are we doing a Garden of Eden for the children to create, or are we doing sustainable gardens for soup kitchens, or are we doing both? If we get enough funding, will we be able to do things like that? So that the children can really get their hands on something, then we talk about how we can serve and work together to make our to show our faith. Pray the prayer. Archbishop has asked us all to pray it before Mass and before meetings. We've given 300 prayer cards to every archdiocese's parish, but we have more available online. And this slide has been updated. It's 19 languages now. I actually videotaped you saying it in Ukrainian so that I can put it up on Facebook, because we've had a bishop who came in and prayed it in Swahili, and then some people from India who prayed it in Mololayam, schedule at a glance, this gives you a little bit of the week that we had talked about, okay? So it's Monday would be check-in, Tuesday would be registration and an opening ceremony, keynote speaker, breakout sessions, and mass. Wednesday, mass would be at 8:30 a.m. This is in, I have materials over here that has this whole schedule laid out in it. Mass is at 8:30, keynote speaker, and then breakout sessions would be following that. And then there'd be a buffet lunch from 1 to 3. The buffet lunch will be near the exhibit hall. We expect a lot of exhibitors. I mean, this is like a Catholic Super Bowl for exhibitors. I mean, just imagine if you like any Catholic writers, I'm gonna not guarantee it, but I'm gonna pretty much say they're gonna be there with a stack of books behind them and a pen in hand and a credit card machine next to them. So I'm sure that even if they're not on the docket of exciting speakers, there's gonna be a lot of exciting people to meet and see and reach out to during the well-being of families. They're doing exhibits now, and we're at 90, and registration hadn't even opened yet. And I'm like, oh, 90 exhibitors. And I looked at the list and I said, do you realize you have 13 orders of sisters on here exhibiting? And they're like, is that unusual? I'm like, I don't know if it's unusual, but I think it says something. You know? So, I mean, really, the exhibitors are going to be very interesting. I'm going to be very interested to see how it all plays out. But I said, we could reach out to the sisters and see if they want to do anything in the youth conference or, you know, as a display or something engaging. But, you know, I think there's going to be a lot of people there that talk about it. There's actually going to be an area called Ask a Bishop. And bishops are going to take turns being there to talk about vocation. So I want to sign up. You know, so, I mean, they're going to have a lot of engaging things. EWTN, Salt and Light, and Catholic TV are all going to have live shows going the whole time, every day, in the hallways. So you'll be walking right by their studios and seeing who they're interviewing and watching their programming live. So it's going to be really exciting.
Thank you.